So let me tell you now the story of when David became what? King. How many know he became king? But it didn't happen overnight. In fact, he was anointed king. He was chosen king at a young age. But it wasn't until he was older, where his gifts were developed, that he was finally crowned king in front of all God's people. This story is found in 1 Samuel chapter 16. If you want to read it at home, you look at 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 1. That's where we're picking up this story. In fact, this story involves a few people. It involves David, whom we'll meet in a few moments. But there's also two other characters. There's Jesse. Who knows who Jesse is? Jesse is David's father. Jesse is the house of Jesse, which David came from. And Jesse had lots of boys. He had 8 children. He had 8 young boys as his children. And then there's also a man named Samuel. How many know Samuel as well? So one day, Samuel went to Jesse's house, and there he said, "Bring forth your boys. God has chosen one of your children to be the king. Welcome the 7 sons that he had." Jesse brought how many sons? 7. Let's count them. Right over here, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But guys, did you know how many sons does he have? 8. I think he's missing one, but we'll find out what happened in the story. So these 7 sons were brought before Samuel. Samuel had an important job. From these men, he was gonna choose the next king of Israel. So he walked and he prayed. In fact, he invited them. The Bible says they came to a sacrifice where they were worshiping God. In the presence of God, Samuel would walk before each man, and they would walk before him, and he would ask God, "God, look at this one. He's tall, he's big, he looks like a king. He could rule over everyone. God, is this the son you've chosen to be king of Israel?" And God would speak to Samuel and say, "No, you are not the one." And they looked down, and the brothers were like, "Oh, it has to be me." And you know how brothers are competitive, right? They're like, "Oh, it's me, it's me, it's me. No, it's me." And they're all looking at each other. And they went one by one. He said, This one has to be him. Look at him. He's handsome. He's great. He's good. He's talented. Here is the next king of Israel." And God would look at him and speak to Samuel and say, "No, that's not him." And they would be all back and forth. And before you know it, Samuel walked by all 7 of these young men. And he stopped there and he said, "God, you sent me to the house of Jesse. I've walked before the sons that he's brought toward to me, but I still haven't found the king." So Samuel went to Jesse and said, "Jesse, something's up. God told me to come to your house to anoint the next king, but I haven't done it yet. Is there anyone else?" And you know what Jesse said? Jesse said, "Oh yeah, I have one more boy. But I didn't think he was important enough. I didn't think he was good enough. He's just a shepherd boy. He's out taking care of the sheep. I didn't even think he was good enough to come and be in the line with my other sons. So I left him out there." And Samuel looked at him and said, "What? Bring him to me." And so before you know it, in front of all his brothers, the one who felt like he wasn't special, the one who felt like he was forgotten, the one who was gifted and talented and being used by God, but feeling like he was little and forgotten, the youngest of the brothers was brought before Samuel. Please welcome David, the shepherd boy. So David, the shepherd boy, came. And there before his brothers, they were all shocked because Samuel prayed and asked, "Is this the one you've chosen to be king over all of Israel? Is this shepherd boy the one that will shepherd and take care of God's people?" And God spoke to Samuel that day and said, "This is the one, because man looks on the outside, but God looks at the..." He looks at the heart, guys. You can be the most talented, gifted person in the world, but if you don't have this right, You'll never accomplish what God has for you. See, what set David apart was he was a worshiper. He was a warrior. He was a shepherd whom God gave gifts to. But because of his heart, he used them for God. And on that day, boys and girls, on that day, the Bible says that Samuel took a ram's horn filled with oil, which was symbolic of anointing. And he went to little David in front of all of his brothers. He said, David, you are anointed. You are chosen. The gifts, the talents that you have will be used to bless and take care of God's people. And on that day, in front of his father, in front of the father who even thought he wasn't good enough, in front of his brothers that were probably jealous and comparing and saying, what, how? In front of them all, God took the anointing and it was placed upon David. It flowed and it flowed from head to toe. He was anointed. And what that meant, guys, he was set apart for God. And little did you know, guys, he was anointed with oil. But after he developed his gifts as a shepherd, as a warrior, and most importantly, as a worshiper, God crowned him king of all Israel. Boys and girls, David is no different than any of you. You too are crowned with many crowns. You are created by God. You will serve God. You will use your gifts and talents to change the world for Jesus Christ. Give him praise and glory.